Namaste and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to do a recipe that's going to take your dessert to another level. It's going to make a good dessert into ooh-la-la. So this recipe is called sweet paste cookie and it has multiple uses. You can see how I've used it in my brownie recipe, and today I'm going to show you the process of how it's made and what can be different ways of using it. So let's get started. So the process for both the cookies is the same. The only difference is in the ingredients. To make the cocoa sweet paste, we are going to replace 20 grams of flour with 20 grams of cocoa powder. Make sure that the dry ingredients ratio to the wet ingredient ratio stays the same. Take butter in a bowl. Start with softening the butter a bit. Let's add icing sugar to this. Add the flour. Add milk. There is a crumbly texture of the dough. You can start binding it with your hand. So once the cookie dough is ready, let's wrap it in cling wrap and keep it in the refrigerator for at least 20 to 30 minutes. I'm just gonna take almost half of the dough that we've prepared, and now I'm just gonna keep it in between two parchment paper and I'll start rolling it. Good thing about this rolling pin is that it has ring, which will ensure a homogeneous thickness throughout. I'm gonna keep the thickness 2.5 mm right now. And if you do not have this kind of a rolling pin, don't worry, you can just use a steel scale and just, you know, insert it once the dough is sheeted out, and you can just measure the thickness. Make sure you apply equal pressure all around so that you get even thickness of the dough at the edges as well as at the center. So the dough is ready and is sheeted evenly, but we are not going to cut it immediately. Now we're going to go place it in the refrigerator again so that, you know, it becomes a little more firm when we cut it, so the petals or the design doesn't fall apart. If you're working in a colder condition, you don't really need to keep it in the refrigerator, but I always prefer to keep it in the refrigerator and let it be a little firm before cutting it. So we put this in the refrigerator also because the cookie dough is heavy in butter. If you're using some other kind of fat which doesn't melt at room temperature, then the case would be different. I know that baking can be tiring, but the reward is of course the end product. Another reward can be if somebody you love helps you. And I'm calling my husband to help me today. Yeah, right. Just place it on this, move it a little, let it dance and pick it up. We'll remove the extra dough later. Let's remove the excess dough. Now it's getting a little difficult to work around the edges. That's because the temperature of the room has already gotten a little higher. So I'm going to again put it back in the refrigerator. After it's refrigerated, it's much easier to get out of these. So I'm placing it in a preheated oven and I'm going to bake it at 180 degrees Celsius for at least 15 to 20 minutes. Once the cookie is out of oven, we're going to let it cool for at least 20 to 30 minutes. There are multiple uses of this cookie. You can use chocolate or milk ganache and make sandwich cookies out of this. Or you could also place it on brownies like I have done to give it a very cute look. Use different cookie cutters to make probably teddy bear cookies or cookies shaped like crown. There's no limit to your creativity in this. So comment below if you would like to see any other recipes that, you know, you want to learn. And don't think that baking is only about sweet dishes. Check out my savory recipes right here. And see you soon.